Welcome to another Cure for Conflict. I'm Bilal. As seen in the media, our government makes a lot of questionable decisions. One of their biggest is their stance on immigration reform. The amount of money or remittance sent back to Latin America and the Caribbean last year totaled over $63 billion, with most of it going to support families in Mexico and Latin America, with most of it coming from the US, according to Inter-American Dialogue. Overall, last year, remittance grew far more than the US economy as a whole. Mexicans accounted for over $23.6 billion sent back to Mexico. To send that much money home on what is most likely a minimum wage salary suggests that migrant workers are working so hard they don't even have time to think about the heinous acts that Trump and his administration keep complaining about, let alone do them. However, this is not to say that every immigrant is inherently an angel, which is the stupidest thing that every person is a rapist. There are bad eggs in every sizable population, but the point is that they are a statistical minority, as only 20% of the immigrants deported under the Obama administration had been previously convicted of a serious crime, according to the New York Times. To top it all off, the 11 million plus undocumented immigrants that currently reside in the United States contribute about $11.84 billion annually, which is based on a 2012 estimate. The tax contributions are currently estimated at being $12.6 billion, which means if Trump wants to deport all these people based on their status and their status alone, he will be losing a lot, and I mean a lot, of funding. Meaning all that money he wants to put into defense and a greater police presence definitely will not be happening without the help of all these people. On top of that, a lot of money is going to be deducted from Social Security services and other public welfare-based departments. Meaning all those people that deserve aid will be getting next to nothing, which puts their welfare in jeopardy. So if Trump wants to deport all these people based on their status and status alone, he and his administration are going to be shooting themselves in the foot and then some. The cost to construct the wall is an estimated $4 million per mile, and constructing an additional 700-mile wall along the US-Mexico border will cost, I don't know, say, $2.8 billion. And on top of that, there's the cost of labor. And immigrant laborers, which account for 20% of the labor force, will not be building that wall on the cheap. Meaning get ready to fork over $22 an hour to unionized US bricklayers. On top of the cost of the wall and its construction, deporting people isn't cheap. Deporting one undocumented immigrant ranges from $8,313 to $23,000, depending on who's doing the estimation. Multiply that by 11.3 million and you have an unimaginably high price tag to deport every single undocumented migrant in the country. I mean, it doesn't really matter how much you spend or build, as there'll always be someone who's willing to dig tunnels and find ways around blockages for way cheaper than what it costs to build a wall or mass deportation. I mean, ask El Chapo, but he knows a few guys who can do it. Thank you for watching today's Cure for Conflict. Be sure to like our Facebook, follow our Twitter and Instagram, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you and good night.